I got 7 o'clock. Oh, meeting order, roll call.
Here, Westbrook.
Yep.
Trigger.
Here.
Lane.
Here.
Bucks.
Here.
Thank you.
Here.
No public forum, consent agenda.
Those building permits are signed, and I'd ask that we would amend the agenda to a closed session.
Okay, is there a motion on the consent agenda?
I'll make it.
Second?
I'll second it.
Roll call.
Trigger.
Yes.
Spanky.
Yes.
Huss.
Yes.
Lane.
Yes.
Okay, June financial report.
Okay. Just a few comments on this. So this would be the fiscal year ending report. And again, just a few comments. Nothing really on that top part. That top part is replaced by a checking account. So the thing of note there is down in the electric fund, where it started off the month negative and ends positive. But within the receipts, there's a $50,000 transfer from the electric capital equipment fund. So that's, you know, we needed to have that $50,000 in there to have a little ending balance when we got to the end of the year. When you go down through the capital funds, you see there's a lot of transfers that occur at the end of the year. In the fire department, we transfer any remaining amount of their budget gets transferred into this capital account. In this year, virtually only a few hundred dollars, $748. Past years, it's been $10,000 and $15,000. This year, they did. They bought some different equipment, and they had to pay for all of those physicals this year. Kind of hit their budget a little bit harder than normal. That Colby Library Fund has an expense out of it of $2,800. What that is was the amount still owing on the library project. Now, the library board had approved using those Colby Library funds to pay off the remainder of the project. So as we get down to through this report, you'll see that the library project now has zero balance. They do still have a little bit of revenue coming in, and that will go back in to replenish this Colby Library Fund money. But as of now, project is paid off. I jump down several lines. We get down to Chief Blackhawk. Where the chief shows a receipt of $2,228. That is the remainder of the HPC budget for the year. So that's any money that was left over that they wanted to transfer into the Chief Blackhawk fund. Now, I believe it was this time, we also paid roughly that amount, about $2,400, that paid back out of that account to the restoration firm who was in and did the restoration work, the cleaning of the statue. So that's good to go for several years. Next line down talks about the log cabin. And see, it has a balance of $15.57, so it finally broke above zero, which would have it pay off the project completely, the log cabin restoration project. There is $400-some being paid in these bills for supplies for their pancake breakfast. So it's not quite paid off yet, but it will be shortly. Skip down a few lines too. We get to the SCEF restroom project and shows the receipt of $17,245. That's actually a transfer from sales tax. So that's the amount of money that the city would have put into that, was $17,245. We had a little in-kind labor on that, so we were at $19,700. On our cost for that restroom project, original budget on that for city expenses was $18,700. So slightly over budget on that one. Skipping down two lines to where you see the library project. It has those revenues for the receipts for the month. About $5,200 of that comes from the library budget again. They had money set to it. Were not spent during the fiscal year, so the remainder of their budget was transferred into that. Largely because they were closed for those couple months and didn't pay staff during that time. So that money went towards the project, and then the project is paid off. So skipping down a few lines again to the streetscape. I zeroed out this little account because we're done with this now, to where the $9,766 that was paid to electric, that was paid for, we had that internal TIF debt, so that was repaid back to the electric. So the amount still owing to the electric is $156,000. And the SCEF sign grant that shows the revenues coming in to square that out. We got revenues from the community club and the men's club. And then the city also had to transfer some money from sales tax. So we transferred $3,013, which was quite a little bit less than what our original budget was on that of $4,500. Just want to point out the capital funds to you, the general capital fund and the public works fund and the electric fund. They still have funds in them, but the general fund, that's roughly the amount of the new car. It's really close to that amount. Public works, really nothing pending on that. And the electric capital fund, that's where we took that $50,000 and transferred it to the electric fund. When there's money in there, we would transfer that back into the capital fund. Little note on the general capital fund is that as of last Thursday, our old John Deere mower really took a bad hit, blew the motor on that old four-wheel steer John Deere. And I think the staff just thinks that you pretty much just need to either try to sell it just as is and somebody needs to get a motor, or you just scrap it, but it's not worth getting fixed up. We do have another mower that we have used exclusively for a sprayer. You always keep a sprayer on it. Now we'll just put the deck back on that. That'll be the third mower for now. Okay. Note on the street construction on the next page. So that's balanced then as of the year's $86,000 that's in the street capital fund. So we're getting to where we can think about doing a street project again next year. Figure about another, say, $40,000 available next year. You get up to about $125,000 in there that we could devote to a street project. So that's gets to where we can do a pretty substantial street project. I'm interested in your comments on the pothole filter, street patching, with the guy who came in and shot the mix into the potholes and some of the low spots.
All ones I go through were fine, except there was a mess.
They didn't do some of them yet because the fellow could only do so much, and we had him come in and do things that were related to Carnival. So big streets around town, the detour up past like Bob Loftus Place, parade route, those things got done. And there's still quite a little bit more that needs to be done. We figured that we could commit $5,000 to doing this. Well, that little bit that they did around town was $3,900. So I know there's a lot more work that we probably could do if we want to commit some more money to it. Just interested in your thoughts.
How much do we have to cut? Do you have any idea on potholes or that?
Well, it's not that we're even really doing potholes. It's fixing low, really low spots, bigger areas, areas dropped out by the curbs, bad utility cuts, that type of stuff.
How much more are we talking?
Well, I had originally thought just another $1,100, but we could probably do another $3,000 or $4,000.
So the rest of the money comes from that?
From road use tax.
You know what streets you're talking about? I guess I can't picture in my head a street that we have that's that bad.
One of the main ones is Second Street past Methodist Church.
South of the library.
South of the library.
That's one of the ones we were going to fix at one time. Is that on the list?
And that's really on next one. That's one of the next ones on the list. The other one that really still needs a lot more attention, although they did some of it, is Sixth Street past K's and Joe Rydell's and down past there.
That's another one.
But that's on, that's, that would, I'm really on the short list to hopefully do maybe some next year.
I love that patching last.
It's a good patch.
On the last 5 years?
Yeah, oh yeah. I like to think so. We really needed to do some pothole work. We've been putting it off because we wanted this guy to come shoot the stuff in instead of using cold mix, so it lasts a lot better.
So is there a benefit to getting it done now, say next year? Price-wise?
Yeah, I would almost argue that there's not, because we don't have enough money to put together a real substantial project. I think
maybe we should wait till next year after we figure out what our road project is going to be, so we don't do that one quick.
You know, I wouldn't.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Unless it needs deteriorating.
We wouldn't do the bad ones. The potholes off the road, that's a.
Yep.
I'd assume they would want some of the potholes fixed here.
And the other one that gets talked about is continuing to try to fix something on Lakeshore Drive. Very low use street, but some streets just in terrible shape.
I think anybody who lives by it should have to.
Special assessment, I think.
I wouldn't want to put that on a high priority, just to put it. I don't drive in that way anyway.
That's where your garage is going to be, huh?
I would think there's, on a main travel road like High Street, there ought to be some potholes we can fix a few things in. The public expects decent roads.
Okay. Well, we won't do too much then, but we'll continue to get the potholes fixed. Basically, that's it on the financial report. Any questions or comments? We need to approve the financial report, then I'll ask you to approve that resolution that authorizes those transfers that we just discussed.
I make the motion to approve it.
Second?
I'll do it.
Roll call.
Thank you.
Yes.
Laney?
Yes.
Obama?
Yes.
Schrader?
Yes.
Cus?
Yes.
Do we need the resolution? 11-14?
Yep.
I'll make a motion that we approve resolution 11-14.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call.
Laney?
Yes.
Schrader?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Cus?
Yes.
Obama? Yeah, I do have a few things for you. We got this request for children playing signs to go up in this area, one block further to the west from here, around the intersection of Madison and 3rd. And just with the rationale being that there's a lot of kids in the area. Absolutely.
You know,
yeah,
so I mean, it's not that I don't live, because, you know, I'd love to have one out by our house, but you wouldn't believe on that small stretch of dead end how fast I'm going to go on our house. And there's a lot of kids around there in the summer, so I just don't know if they're effective.
Well, we had this discussion before, and the question was, well, really, aren't they just basically supposed to designate public gathering places, basically parks and that type of stuff? We've had this request before, and it's been turned down.
Where did you start? Where did you stop? Mm-hmm. I mean, do we believe that these kids are more important than these kids? I mean, that's...
Because every parent would like to have one. But the sign's not going to stop
have
these kids.
But there's some signs up by school, but I think they're just pedestrian signs. I don't know if they have any of the kids playing signs.
Ted, you don't think it helps, do you, or do you?
I kind of agree with the comment of where do you start and where do you stop. We have parks.
It looks like it won't be erected.
All right. That's fine. I know this really excites some of you.
I can
see the excitement from that.
And some of you, it excites less. But here's the Rag Bride packet. If we wanted to apply to be an overnight town for next year's rent.
Can I have that packet?
I know I wasn't here last time, but it would really, really enhance our objective of becoming, you know, a writer-friendly community, and I mean, it would take it to the next level for sure. But again, I know it's a very challenging and difficult event.
Okay. I'm not against Rag Bride, just all the rowdies that come with it. Usually like the tour bus kind of people that follow, like Mortality of the Locusts, like one of the flags. And every town.
Or something like that.
Don't hold back, you're a nobody.
I have no problem with the people that like to pedal it. Just.
So put in there, no locust in the flag.
No.
But everybody else, welcome. Oh, I just, you know, I think it's done really terrific things for Carroll. I mean, obviously it's a much, much bigger community and a lot more volunteer pool to call from. But I mean, they've really made it a material event and have really, you know, rallied around it. And it's, like, you can't go to Carroll on a Friday and not see people wearing the Rag Bride t-shirts. I mean, it's really, it's been great. But, you know, we do a lot of great things, you know.
So, what was your thought about it when you graduated?
I would tell you that it's a huge, massive undertaking to get everything organized to do this. And they come here and they spend a lot of money and you get your name out there, and in the end it's well worth all of the effort. That's my opinion. Oh no, the cheese.
Is there a police issue?
I would like to say that it's the worst thing we've ever done since I've been here. I mean, it's not that I don't like Rag Bride, it's great. Lakeview's not set up for Rag Bride. We just don't have the area for the amount of people that they bring in. We have a couple ways in and a couple ways out, and we just don't, we're just not set up for it. It's great for Carroll, it's great for Storm Lake and some of these bigger towns. They have areas to handle them, we don't.
Where do most of them stay at the end of the day?
Wherever they can throw a tent.
We did big campgrounds, of course, at Camp Crescent was basically support vehicles at Camp Crescent and up the school. Big campgrounds for individuals at Speaker Park. And then they have all of these massive groups, and I understand the groups are even bigger now than they were had been before. But we did Arrowhead as a group campsite. We did Shotgun Hill as group campsites. And Ice House Point, I guess, was probably the biggest group campsite.
The designated sites, and then
we'll
just kind of did whatever.
Sure, yeah, and then you gotta, you'll have significant housing for people who request that, and yards for people to stay in.
Well, I would agree it was a wonderful thing for the community, but we struggled to get volunteers. It's almost like doing carnival.
Well, it's so short after. I mean, it's so quickly after.
Too close to carnival.
So we could hardly get one. A couple guys sent the boots up to chuckle up, and had one guy with a bad arm and another couple doing it. We struggled with that.
We put it up backwards.
Yeah.
But it's there. Well, here's what I got to say, and this is as a businessman, not as a city councilman. It's the best thing that's ever happened in my business. Because I'll tell you, in one night, I put $10,000 in the bank that I didn't have the night before. So that's what it does for me.
I'll second that.
Yeah.
There's two places in town that's going to be.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
And like I said, I don't mind Rag Bride. It's just the idea that I just think we just can't handle it. We had more problems last time. And it wasn't just the people. It's just that once you get them in here, you have a heck of a time getting people in and people out. You've got more sites here. And the other problem you have is whenever you have a problem, well, they don't have a band on, they're not part of Rag Bride. Well, that's bull. If they're here, they're here because of Rag Bride, whether they paid or not. And we just don't have room for it. But yeah, it's great for the, well, the men's club too.
So what do? They send us out. Are they
thinking
this area? Is that
No, we've received one for the past couple of years too, that they send it out to towns who have hosted before or those who have the capacity to host overnight stops.
Marcia, as a newspaper, what have you got to say?
Well, I've always said that if it comes through again, I'm in early retirement. But my question is it possible just to get them through here as a go-through instead of an overnight type deal? Because I think we could handle that far better I remember last time we struggled with the feeding thing, and we're shorter on restaurants now than we were when they came through before.
Well, we had some policy decisions that we made last time too that said only local food, you know, only local vendors, and
right,
you need to look at how those policy implications affected everything. We did have some food problems.
Yeah, we did. But is it possible just to get them through as a ride through? Because Wall Lake makes out like a bandit when we host it here, you know.
It's conceivable.
Yeah. I think that would be a good solution.
Can we rent 40 acres of ground outside for alfalfa and then we can camp out there?
People have done that. Serious.
And right across from Spike, you just rent that and put alfalfa 1 year.
A few acres of land north of
Like the state Lakewood.
The other thing is, too, since they're going through Carroll this year, would the possibility of their coming through this area again even be feasible?
Well, I would think that would be unlikely because it was Storm Lake,
yeah,
Carroll.
Yeah, highly unlikely, wouldn't it?
Other than this is still primarily a south route.
And the idea of too many people that are already saying no, so that's why they're begging everybody out.
Would it be possible to contact some of the local biking groups and, you know, see if we can't get their commitment to assist if they were to be willing to run things or something? I mean, and I know a lot of them ride, but...
Well, if you do, we could ask them for help. Chris, did you have something that you thought would
help? No. I'm good.
So does everybody want to fill it out and see what happens or no?
I would say yes.
I think we should at least... you know, stay on their radar. Because if we, you know, don't submit applications, we, you know, then we're...
We're not doing what we've been telling everybody that we're going to try.
Do that.
Well, we'll fill it out.
We do have to take it.
No.
You do not have to
take it. Step one, if they come like 2 weeks before and ask you, do you still want, you could say no to that.
No, you're like January.
I came to that meeting the last time.
Mm-hmm. And they send out a notebook that has to be filled out. Okay, City Hall roof?
City Hall roof, maybe the end of this week, first part of next week, they'll be here to do the City Hall roof. Just a couple of different updates for you. Gus Cleveland sent him the bill and haven't heard no response.
How many times have we given?
But he'll get 30 days to pay the bill.
So what's our next step?
Let's go from
there. Yeah, good, yeah.
Yeah, it's
at
the old building.
Anything else?
Nope. Send him a notice to cure the default and refer it to our attorney.
Correct the process. Anybody else think that's right or wrong?
Just make everybody else pay. What's the council want to do about that tree next year? What do we do? Are we going to trim a tree or something that was going to...
We already decided to trim that, didn't we?
Which?
The tree was not the same at all. Are we done trimming that?
So we trimmed it back as far as what was hanging, really hanging over the roof. And there's some stuff that's right at the edge of the roof line and stuff too.
I just want to make sure I'm walking the right line.
As far as update on the Sac Beach infrastructure, just that Schneider Engineering's begun the work on that. They've begun some of the design on the sanitary sewer and on the water. So we'll be hearing more about that here hopefully in the next upcoming weeks. Same thing with the FEMA electric. We got the contract in place with Stanley with that change about the basically we don't pay them until we don't pay them their final payment until we get all the final documents. They were agreeable to that. Still working on that Lake Preservation Association. Another organizational meeting would be next Tuesday. One of the things that we hope to accomplish at that meeting is to get everything laid out for a public meeting to introduce the BLPA and to update everybody on the status of the watershed improvement project. We want to do that on Saturday, the 6th of August, okay? And we really want to cater this
like
more...
what time?
9 a.m.
Okay.
We want to do a Saturday morning meeting. and cater it really towards our seasonal residents. That's why we would do a weekend meeting like that. What I would like to do is to be able to send out a notice to our seasonal folks, everybody out around the lake, their utility. Probably it'd be a couple hundred stuffers that we would need to put in their bills. I don't propose to do that for everybody, but just for the lake residents. Maybe some of our owners in the watershed. That WERB grant that they talked about applying for the fish structure, DNR's kind of had a change of heart about whether they would want to apply for that right now and how that works in the timing. Basically, they're not going to apply for it. The kind of the higher ups in the state DNR recommended that they not proceed with that just right now.
Is there a better reason than that?
I do have a reason, Tony. I have to tell you. Ben sent me an email about that.
Okay. But it was rational, it just wasn't another opportunity to receive something.
I want to check the reason before I tell you. See, I tell you that it was just that it's kind of not within their time. Their schedule of wanting to do a lot of watershed work before they do inlet work.
Okay. Well, that would make sense. That's why I was just curious about if it was, you know, just a sequence of events things or just that they don't think they should do it.
Wednesday through Friday is the city management summer meeting in Altoona. And then we're going to take just a little bit of a family vacation. We've gone on Monday, then, so we'll be back on Tuesday.
Maybe a cool off day.
Going to Branson area.
Sure, it's a lot cooler there.
Yeah. That wire, you know, you're there.
Because you want to.
Ah, yes, family vacation.
Careful with that.
That's it.
That's it. Bellman, what's that? Is that their start Monday?
There. She called today and actually said, plan on all day tomorrow. They'll be here to do the initial work as far as involves a lot of the interview questions and stuff will happen tomorrow. Field work will happen a little bit later on. So, sorry.
How long is the project like that take?
They would, she'll come down and do all the interview stuff and get that taken care of tomorrow. Give me some prep work as far as a lot of it is. We'll have a couple hundred test invoices that they look at and follow through and make sure everything's done proper on that. And so I'll have however much time I need to get those things pulled. We'll get the field work scheduled, and the field work has been running 2 to 3 days.
Okay, real quick, I got one thing. I was approached by somebody who wanted to put some siding on their garage, and obviously they want to put tin siding. Which is really nothing but corrugated steel. But our ordinance says it can't be vertical. It doesn't say it can't be horizontal. They want to put it horizontal. It's not going to be white. It's going to be the same color as the siding on their house. They're going to put the same color trim on it. I don't think we have a leg to stand on to tell them no. But they want some kind of approval from the council before they do it. They don't have to tear it down. I think we should just tell them to go ahead.
Are
we opening up the can of worms? You've already opened up the can of worms. You drive around the lake, there's two buildings already like that. One of them's a pole barn. It's already built. It's got vertical siding on it.
Okay.
It's out there. I can drive you right to it. Okay. I don't think that the building looks fine to me. I don't want to see these people out tear down the building, but it doesn't meet our ordinance. This one, I believe, does meet. All it says, our ordinance says, you cannot use vertical corrugated steel. We're going to use horizontal corrugated steel.
I would say it's not really what the spirit of the law was intended to do.
And that's why they want an answer before they do it, because they don't want to put it on there. They've talked to all their neighbors.
I know we struggled with the planning and zoning back in the day about how they wanted to write that. And, you know, it was... Their original intention here dealt with over at Valliers, and then Valliers got this home to the west of them. They made it into a shop and put side this corrugated siding. Mm-hmm.
And the colors are what people object to, isn't it?
Yeah. Not necessarily. And I guess along the way, we've told people no a lot of times.
Did everything on Jim's set, he had to change it? Or did he stop it before he got there?
We did do something with that garage.
Well, I could...
I remember it was something that, so I don't remember what it was, man.
But he still has vertical corrugated steel siding, but it's only in the gable.
I remember there was an issue over there, I remember that.
Anybody else got anything?
If you'd like me to give him a call tomorrow, I'd like to let him know what you guys think.
But isn't the spirit of the ordinance, shouldn't the ordinance be rewritten to reflect the spirit of it? I mean, it just doesn't seem quite fair. I don't know how external this matters, but...
I really think we would be better off allowing it for all garages, just that we get some garages that get something on them besides wood that needs paint. There's probably 10, 15 other garages in town that maybe would do something similar.
It would look better
than no paint at all.
It would match the homes.
Yeah. And it does say that it still has, our ordinance says it has to be residential in nature.
Residential in nature.
And it has to have the, has to maintain the pitch and all that other stuff. I think common sense is going to do it, but whatever it decides.
What if it's such a big vertical and start horizontal?
He could just do it on his own, but he doesn't want to do that. Because he don't want to pee up the rope, is what he doesn't want to do.
Well, you don't like to say it says horizontal, or it says vertical.
Okay. I'll tell them that nobody threw a big fit. How about that?
Do we need a motion to go into closed session?
I'll make it.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call.
Bigger.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Us?
Yes.
Laney?
Yes.
Overmark?
Yes.
Could you indicate the reason, the exception you're going into closed session for?
21.5C.
Which is?
Pending litigation.
Okay, do you have a motion to have a closed session?
I'll make that motion.
Second?
Roll call.
Spencer?
Yes.
Us?
Yes.
Laney?
Yes.
Overmark?
Yes.
Dave?
Yes.
Do you have a motion to adjourn?
I'll make that motion.
Second?
I'll second.
Any adjournment?